in some cases, you'll be married, there'll be men who are cheating on their wife with various prostitutes, for example, okay, or various women. And this has been going on for years. And sometimes I've actually heard where the advice is like, oh, that's his problem. You know, just focus on your kids and stay in this marriage. And I mean, that is very, Hafsa, your face, I know. That's the type of toxic advice that many of these women are getting, as if it's like, it's okay, you know, that's his problem. But what we're not realizing is, look at that. Number one, it is obviously it's a complete disrespect for the nikah. It's a disrespect for the woman, but it is also sending a very toxic message to the children, right? Mm-hmm. Because the children are seeing this and they're thinking that, you know, that this is okay. And this is okay to either do or to put up with. So not only is it like, oh, he's not beating me up, he's just sleeping around. Well, that's also not okay. So that's something I think needs to be really, really made clear, because I've seen a lot of these cases.
I'm glad that you mentioned that, Ustadha. Actually, someone just mentioned in the chat that my mother is being told that you have to be strong so that your children can be strong whenever she's being abused. And that it's that kind of psychological kind of mind, like retwisting, reframing something that's absolutely not okay and making it seem like that's this, you know, weakness is strength and strength is weakness.
And I would say in that case, you absolutely have to be strong so your children will be strong. And showing strength in that case is leaving an abusive situation. That is being strong. And in fact, if you don't show that strength, and like Sheikh said, we're not talking about just normal disagreements. We're not talking about just the disagreements that happen in every marriage. Talking about abusive situations that you have tried to change. You have tried. You've involved family. You've involved counselors. You've maybe even involved police. I mean, you've done what you can to try to stop this abuse, and it isn't stopping. Now, in those cases, strength is leaving that situation, and that's important because you are modeling for your children. And if you stay in those situations, you're teaching your daughters that they can stay in situations like that. That it's okay for men to abuse them, and this becomes a cycle. And unfortunately, you're typically teaching your sons to do the same thing to their wives. So it becomes a cycle where you're modeling. That's what children are learning. So you don't want that for your daughter. You don't want that for your son. And you should model that strength and not put up with it.